So it's almost April. How exciting is that? Honestly, March flew by again like crazy, and I'm not ready yet, but my spreads are ready, so I'm gonna show you today how I actually set up my spreads for April. It started with these green washi tapes that I ordered from AliExpress, and I will link them down below. My theme for April is actually green, so I also looked up pictures that would suit this theme. Basically anything that was green, flowery, and reminded me of spring. And I'm gonna set it up similar to how I did March, so like a cover page and a calendar page. And then I have my daily spreads right after that. I started off with a new stamp that I got. It's a calendar stamp, and those things are super handy. And as you see, I messed up once, and then I did it twice, and then I actually did it three times because I didn't like the melt liner color, so I actually went for a Crayola super tip marker, then slightly more dark green because the green was a little light. And I used some stamps from HEMA, which you can see here, to make the word April. And I really like this method actually. You just press down really hard, and then you, in this case, get a round stamp on your paper, and then you can cut it out and use it to make a word, because that's how stamp works, you know. Another thing that I wanted to include in my spread was some brown paper. So this is actually really cheap brown wrapping paper that I use quite a lot. So you rip it apart and you can put it on the paper however you want it. And I actually did put it on a little too close to the middle of my journal, so you will also see me trying to fix that later on, because that was kind of stupid. But you know, you learn. See, trying to fix it, but couldn't fix it honestly. So I eventually had to cut off the edges. So there we go. Now it looks good. And now I start just placing all the elements that I want to have on my cover page on the cover page. So I have the letter for April. I had this little calendar thingy that I actually redo at some point because of the green. And I just take some pictures to make it more interesting. And one of the pictures that I wanted to include, or actually the quote, is "Bloom with Grace." I like the quote. I really liked how it was written down. And I think it's a good thing for spring, you know. Spring is coming up, feels like nature is alive, and so am I. So I thought that would be really nice. Quote and picture to include. So now I will just move it around a bit, see what looks best. And yeah, this is really a creative process that goes on in every spread that I make. I just try to move it around a little bit, see what works, and then when I'm happy with it, I'm gonna stick it on. I decided to use the, I would say, moss green washi tape from the set. So it's a little bit of a darker green, maybe a little olive green. And yeah, in a way it's more fall than spring maybe, but I liked it a little bit more than the really bright greens, or the one that's like almost yellow actually. So that was like the basic color that I'm gonna use in my spreads. So then I put on the letters that I stamped with some glue tape. And the benefit of that tape is that you can kind of move it around. So if it's not straight first try, then you can just move it around, and that's basically how it works. And here I realized that I really hated the green in the calendar, so I decided to do it again. But first, I will put on the pictures because I was really happy about these three pictures and how they would look. So I used a little washi tape beneath it and just put it on there. And as you can see here, I actually switched the calendar to a darker green. It was just one of those Crayola super tip markers, and they're actually quite nice because I usually forget about them, but then I realize that I have basically every single color that I could ever wish for. So I do sometimes go back. And then lastly, I added this to-do stamp, which is also from a new set that I got. And I added some dots because dots make everything look better, honestly. So I usually do dots or stars or flowers or anything to kind of fill up the the spaces. And the very last thing is that I use the Crayola again to make the to-do green. So this is my cover page for April. It's actually super simple, but I really liked how it turned out. And now next up is my calendar page, I guess, monthly overview page, whatever you want to call it. I always have this page and then I never really look at it, so I still don't know why I make it, but usually they look really good, so it's still a fun thing to look back on. And this time I wanted to make the calendar in the middle of the two pages, so what I do is I draw a lot of lines and you'll see how it eventually works out. And I used to do more of like a square calendar, I guess how you would call it, like a more traditional one, but I never really had enough space. So by doing it this way, I can actually add up to two things per day, and I usually only have one thing per day, but sometimes also two, because I only put like anniversaries and birthdays and just those kind of things in here. But if I happen to have more than one thing, I can still fit it in here. So I got some more new stamps, and this one also has numbers, and I hate writing numbers. I just really hate how I write numbers, so I generally use stamps for it. It takes more time than writing it, but it looks better. So you see me finishing the days of the month. And then I wanted to have the brown paper again, similar to on my cover page, so I put it now on the right side of the page. Again, trying to align it as good as possible, and then you just cut the edges again, and then it looks like it actually belongs there. So yeah, I think that can be like a recurring thing in my team for April. So the green will return, of course, but maybe also the brown paper at some point. So here you see it. I kind of like how this page is just growing and growing, and then, you know, at some point I'm usually like, oh no, this doesn't look good, but eventually it works out, so definitely don't worry about it too much. You can always add extra pieces or stickers or dots to make it look good again. So I also use the alphabet stamps again, and I lost the letter. So you see me searching for that letter. I don't know why, but it just ended up in the trash, basically. So here I am cutting off the last letter and then putting it on again. Kind of similar to how I did on the front page, but then instead of doing it horizontal, I did it vertically. So it looks the same, but not the same. And this month is actually the last month that I'll be using my Scribbles That Matter journal, because it's almost full, so I can barely fit April in there, and then it's time to move on to something else. And currently I'm thinking of the A6 Leuchtturm. I actually bought an A6 Leuchtturm, so I'll probably use that one. And yeah, the reason is that I kind of want to have a different challenge, so I think the A6 one is a good new challenge for me. But this month it's still Scribbles That Matter, and I actually loved the Scribbles That Matter journal. It's really good. I love the paper, I love the quality. I was afraid that it would fall apart at some point, but it still hasn't. So I'm actually really surprised. So if you're looking for a new journal, definitely check out the Scribbles That Matter journals. So here I am adding in some extra pictures on this monthly overview, and I did a little stamp that has a quote on it, and again use the green to kind of have that theme again. Added some washi tape. And again, this is also always just a really creative process of seeing what works best, trying to fill up the spaces without making it too full. I wanted to include some stickers as well. I actually need to order new stickers, because I got these last month and I used already a lot of them. So I might order some more at some point. Yeah. This is basically I set up that spread. And I'm kind of sort of not ready for April yet. I don't know. I mean, while I'm filming this, it's still March, but it just all feels so quick and so soon. But I am ready for spring, because I'm kind of feeling the winter blues at this point. So I'm really hoping for some sunshine. So that would be really good. Again, using some stems to fill up the spaces. And I got, I think, 3 new stem sets about 2 weeks ago, and they're all really nice. I have so many stem sets, but these ones are really nice. So I added in some flowers. I actually did something stupid here, because I thought I only had these small stems. So I was thinking, well, let's put 2 together, then it looks nice. And then I realized that there was actually also a stem on there with 2 flowers. So, yay, go me. That was really stupid. But yeah, it's basically finished. So I ended up coloring half of the days with green as well, just to have the color in there again. Maybe eventually I will do all of them, I don't know yet. Colors in some bits also with the green marker, and yeah, that's basically it. So I'm ready for April, but I still need to set up my daily spreads. So right after this I'll start with Monday, and that's perfect about April, it starts on Monday. You have no idea how happy I was about that. So what I usually do for daily spreads is I create kind of the basis that I can work with. So I want to have at least the day of the week in there, the date, a little bit of decoration. So usually it's just the pictures and some washi tape. And I generally like to write or stamp the word to-do there. So that's where I kind of start with my to-dos for the day. So what you see me setting up here for every day is basically setting up every day. So I start with some washi tape. I generally pick like 2 or 3 washi tapes that I want to use in a repetitive way to kind of have the theme in there still. So I picked the green one again, and I got a brown one for my Muji set, which I think matches the brown paper quite well. So in that way I can have the same theme again. And what I also did is I created some headers for the days of the week in a PowerPoint document, and I can maybe show it to you also in a video sometime, because it's actually super easy. You just make the black squares and you write the day of the week. That's basically it, and it's super simple, and you can just print it out and put it on there. It's actually the first time that I did it this way, but yeah, it was really handy to do, so I'll probably do it again at some other point. It's actually quite boring that I'm showing you this, because it's doing the same thing all over again and all over again for a week. And I do try to set up all the spreads for the whole month, like in the beginning of the month, so I can also plan ahead. For this video I only did the first week, but I will be setting up the rest of the month later on, and then yeah, you will probably see the result in a flip through somewhere at the end of the month. But yeah, I don't know, I try to keep it quite simple, because these spreads will grow when I actually use them, and I do a lot of decoration also afterwards. But yeah, it's good to have at least the basics. And I'm also kind of thinking of how I want to do this in my next journal, if I will continue with this style, or maybe make it even more simple, or maybe make it more fancy. I will probably still do daily spreads, because I prefer it over weekly spreads, because I use this journal for both my private stuff and my work, and I always have a lot of stuff to do for work, so that's why I actually switched to these daily spreads. So chances are that I will just do something similar in my new journal, but then in an A6 size, so that will be an interesting challenge. I did really love the look of how this turned out with the black headers, and then the washi tape, and the pictures. So yeah, I was actually quite happy about it, and I do sometimes switch around for each week. But I don't know if I will do it this time or just continue with the same theme throughout the month. So, sticking on the last picture there for this week. And then, of course, the day of the week. And then I still need to include something that says to do and dates. And I recently started using some stamps for that because it's just way easier to do. So I stamped to do on all of the days. Then again, use these small numbers to do the date. Which again, if you write it, is so much faster, but I'm just so upset about my handwriting. And then I also use the green Crayola again to add in the green for every day of the week. And then that's it. So I'm not completely ready for April yet, but at least I have my cover page and my calendar page. And then for the first 7 days of the week, I have my spreads. And I actually really like how it turned out. I love the green. I know it's maybe not super spring, but yeah, it looks good, I think. Thank you for watching and see you later. Bye bye.